Joe Dunn at InfoCision Stadium with University of Akron head football coach Terry Bowden. Day one is in the books as Akron prepares for the 2018 season. And coach, something new on day one. You've got three new football coaches on the staff.
Yeah, you know, we haven't had that much here, but I like a little change. If you've got a coaching staff, well, Chuck Amato just turned 70. He was ready to retire. It was good for him. Did a great job here. But we had some coaches move up and have some great opportunities. But we got three new coaches, Joe Tracy and Marcus Watley and Corey Gribben. Those are all three coaches. And I like a little change because it gives you some new ideas, gives you a little change of flavor in the ideas you're doing offensively and defensively. And it's been a real nice addition with these coaches. They're outstanding coaches, ones we clearly wanted to have here. And they bring in not just some enthusiasm, some energy, but some different ideas that the longer you're in a conference, this is our seventh year, you better change a little bit because everybody gets used to what you do.
Cato Nelson right now emerges as the number one quarterback going into practice. That's something that's positive.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's the last three or four games last year, although we lost a couple of games late, we probably would have lost whoever we played at quarterback in those last two games. But we've been kind of talking about Cato as the guy of the future for a long time, and so I think he's the guy of our present right now. He's up to 215 pounds, very strong, had a great offseason program, and right now it's his job to lose. Now, Alex Remart doing a great job as a redshirt freshman. He'll push. Robbie Kelly's had shoulder surgery after January. He's coming back still from that. But those three are likely going to compete with Cato being a guy that we're excited about the future of our football, not only with him, but with all those quarterbacks.
I know you want to run the ball more this year. Mm-hmm. I have never seen a better group of young running backs here at Akron than the group you have right now.
Well, I tell you, we needed to get them in here. We wanted bigger ones. You know, we had Van Edwards, who runs a 4.4 at 200 pounds, and Deltron Sands is pretty shifty as a smaller back, under 200 pounds. And we've got three. DeAndre White's 230, and Floyd from East Akron's about 225. And then we got Abraham Alcy from Florida. He goes about 245. That's a nice addition to Suggs and some of those other guys that are already in camp. So we've got a lot of at-bats. You know, you can pull your tight end out, put two running backs in. You can do a lot of things. You've got power people on the inside game, on your short yardage. I think we met some of our recruiting needs in getting these football players.
The offense got more good news a few days ago. Jonah Morris, the All-State kid from Hoban, transferred from Indiana. He's been cleared by the NCAA. He'll be eligible immediately with 3 years left to play.
Yeah, Joe, I'm glad you mentioned that because we made a commitment to local athletes, and we have a lot more local athletes right now on our football team. And Jonah really was one of the best athletes, if not the best athlete, in his graduating class 2 years ago at Hoban High School. He went to Indiana. They changed coaching staffs. He needed to come home to be close to his family, and he came and got a waiver to be eligible right now. 6'4" wide receiver. He could play safety, but we need a receiver that's explosive like that. So we're very excited about the big play possibility and the fact that he's one of the best local players from the area.
Defense wins championships, as you know, Coach. You've got a lot of veterans over on that defensive side.
Yeah, if experience is important, then we ought to be pretty dadgum good. I mean, we've got 9 starters back, potentially 10 seniors starting. Maybe that's too much for 19, but we're worried about 18 right now. And that gives us the experience. Hopefully we will not go into any stadium, whether it be Nebraska or any conference stadium, and our guys be nervous or intimidated. They'll be ready to play. So you win championships with defense, you run the ball a little bit better, and you put yourself in a position to win football games, especially late in the season when the wind's blowing sideways and it's awful cold. You win with defense running that football. So I'm excited about it, about our defense. Todd Stroud will now be running the defense along with co-defensive coordinator Joe Tracy, and I think that's a lot of energy too as well. So, boy, we're gonna hang our hat on that defense, and hopefully offensively we'll come along as well.
Boy, a great day for day one. A lot of enthusiasm. Best of luck the rest of camp.
Thank you, Joe. Appreciate it.
Terry Bowden, Don't Remember Zip fans, season tickets on sale now at 1-888-99-ACRON. For Terry Bowden, I'm Joe Dunn for the Zips Digital Network.